question, we are asked to find out the number of consecutive 0 at the end of 100 factorial plus 200 factorial and 100 factorial into 200 factorial. So let's find out the number of consecutive 0 at the end of, let's say, 100 factorial. So that will be a minimum of 100 by 5 plus 100 by 5 square, right? And 100 by 2 plus 100 by 2 square plus 100 by 2 cube till 100 by 2 to the 6. So the minimum will be this value, and this value will be 20 plus 4, 24, right? So the number of consecutive 0 at the end of 100 factorial will be 24. And similarly, if we have to find out the number of the consecutive 0 at the end of 200 factorial, that will be minimum of 200 by 5 plus 200 by 5 square plus 200 by 5 cube and 200 by 2 square, 200 by 2 raised to power 3 till 200 2 raised to power 7. So the minimum will be this value, and this value is going to be 40 plus 8 plus 1, so that will be 49. Okay, so in case of plus, right, in case of 100 factorial plus 200 factorial, so the number of consecutive 0 will be 24, and this is because, let's say, we are given the number AB C 0 0, right, and we have another number as MN P, so that only 1 0, right? So if you go to sum this number, so the number of consecutive 0 at the end, so they will be only be this one, because here we are adding this 0 with P, right? So we have the number of consecutive 0 only is 1. But if we are multiplying this number, so these will be last number will be some XY and 3 times 0, right? So because 2 0 here and 1 0 here, so they get added, so it will be 3 times 0. So XY and then 3 0. So for the case of product, we have 24 plus 49, so that will be 73, and in case of sum, we have 24.